spectrum there, where the frequency spectrum is given to us, and this particular, we are required to comment on the result in detail if this spectrum is sampled first at twice the sampling rate, and secondly, we are required to sample the signal with half the sampling rate. Now, the first job that we are required to carry out here is find out the Nyquist rate. To find the Nyquist rate, again, let us find out the maximum frequency present. The maximum frequency present is this one. So 2 pi f max is 100 pi. This and this is cancelled. What remains is 2 f max is equal to 100, and hence f max is equal to 50 hertz. So the maximum frequency available in my signal is 50 hertz. Now, to obtain the sampling rate correctly, we need to follow this Nyquist criteria that the sampling rate should be twice greater than the maximum frequency. Hence, the proper sampling rate is twice over f max, that is, it should be at least greater than 100 hertz. It should be greater than at least 100 hertz, sorry. So now, again, the first task, the job here is to comment on the result in case it is sampled with a sampling frequency twice greater than the sampling rate and half than the sampling rate. So twice greater than the sampling rate is 200 hertz. So if we sample a signal with a sampling frequency greater than 200 hertz, the spectrum that we are going to obtain is something like this. This is the original signal. Then for next 200, for this particular period, which is almost 200, there will not be any frequency component present. Directly, the frequency component is present at this particular instance. See here, clear cut. The distancing of 200 pi is we will be able to see if we try to plot the frequency spectrum of the signal which is sampled at sampling frequency twice greater than the maximum frequency, right? Now, in case if we don't follow that particular criteria and if we sample the signal with a sampling frequency half than that of the sampling rate, half than that of sampling rate means 50 hertz. If we follow that particular thing and if we try to plot the spectrum of the resulting signal, the spectrum of the resulting signal is, you can clearly see here the overlaps. I feel it is quite clear, the overlaps, the next frequency component starts immediately after the duration of 50 hertz, after the duration of half of that earlier band, the entire band. Okay, so with this 50 hertz, we are going to get the spectrum like this. This is the clear cut overlap of the frequency spectrum. See here, the higher frequencies are, this particular thing is nothing but my aliasing, wherein the higher frequency components, the higher frequency components are taking the form of the lower band, the lower frequency component. This is nothing but aliasing. Why this has happened? Because we have not followed the sampling criteria. And why this particular distancing is there? Because we have followed the sampling criteria, right? So this is the correct choice of my sampling rate if I follow the Nyquist theorem for the task of obtaining the digital signal there. Now I feel with this due discussion, the idea of sampling theorem, the idea of Nyquist frequency now is quite clear to you. I feel it will not be possible for us to discuss further more things in this 1 hour. Some of the notes I have already given to you people. At the same time, I'll be uploading shortly the video. Those are based on resolution, bit length, and many of the other concepts related to quantization. Shortly, I'll be giving you the links of those also. Already those things are there in my notes also. Those things are there shared in the Google Drive also, on Qualcomm as well as on Moodle. You can very well refer those in case you want to have the video lectures on that. Shortly, I'll be providing you the video lecture also. But for this moment of time, let me stop here. I wish you all the best. Stay safe, stay home, and don't forget to complete the quiz that is given on this unit. On this unit, for ETX students, the quiz is uploaded on Moodle. Please don't forget, because earlier we were using Qualcomm platform, but for this quiz, purposefully I have chosen the platform of Moodle. So on Moodle, I have, this quiz will be open on 27th of March. On 27th of March, please log in on Moodle and solve that quiz. In case any doubt is there, please feel free to ask me. Any comment, any doubt, please let me know. And don't forget to refer my notes. All the best. Stay healthy, stay home.